Urimo,
Yeah.
What happened over the weekend?
Bro.
Yeah.
A lot happened, of course.
Yeah. In yeah. terms of betting, before you go to sports, football itself.
Wow. You said betting, right?
Betting, yeah.
On Sunday, we lost by one goal.
Yeah.
Or was it a double chance?
It was
yes.
double chance and their home team
And it's
won.
Your team.
Vigile.
That team,
yeah.
And on Saturday, I don't know, maybe you tell me.
On Saturday, we had actually we lost by two games,
mm-hmm.
But there is a bet we won on our Telegram,
yeah. A mini train bet around how many odds was that?
It was around eight odds. So we had a good stake and we got around 150 USD.
Amazing.
And on Sunday we were close to getting at least 200 USD.
Another mini bet.
Yes, but Feyenoord and Zenit, because we played. I played with over 1.5. Mm. But expect that to be happening every weekend. On Saturday and Sunday we have a lot of games.
Yeah.
So probably we'll be giving them a mini bet, mini train bet of around 10 odds, which mm-hmm. is kind of safe for running the entire day. Mm-hmm. And we had a couple of wins on Saturday, around four wins, back-to-back wins.
Back-to-back wins. So
yeah, on Monday.
Three plus odds for every bet.
Yeah, on awesome. Monday, BetSlip, we won. Actually, on Monday, we won. Then on Tuesday, you lost by a single game. That is Besiktas.
Besiktas, you nil-nil. We had gone for over 1.5 goals.
Yeah.
And then, yeah.
That's
then
all.
We're here now.
Yeah, so like always, we shoot on Wednesday. So we don't know how the match is going to go today.
Yeah.
But either way, we are positive. Mm-hmm. We're going to start with, let me check my bet slip. I have around how many teams? This time around, I have six teams for Saturday bet slip. And those guys are saying we give them a team plus the league. We'll try.
Yeah, you know your teams comes from some certain leagues that a person who started betting
recently
yesterday or another day might not really tell. So yeah, it's good to say those leagues.
Yeah, sure. So I have six teams and here we go. First match around 2 p.m. on Saturday. We have the Bundesliga 2 match. That is Holstein Kiel taking on Kaiserslautern. Right, that is over 2.5 German Bundesliga 2. And on later on around 3:30 I have a team, I'm sure you know this match, Sturm Graz 2 taking on FC Donbann. That is the Austria Liga 2.
Liga 2, yeah.
Yes. Then there is this team called BG. That is over 1.57 odds. Then we have the third match. I have BG Pathum United taking on Port FC. That is a league, Thailand league. We call it Thai League One. Yes. Then from Bundesliga, that's, have I given market for that? Over 1.5, 1.18. The fourth match is from Bundesliga, that is Bayern Munich, taking on Frankfurt. That is over 2.5, 1.34 odds. And the fifth game is Kifisia. AE Kvisia taking on Giannina.
That is Greece.
Yeah. Thank you. That's Greece. We call it Super League One. Over 1.5, 1.22 odds. And the last match, we call it Solentuna versus Pitea. That is the Sweden.
Sweden League.
Yes. Etan Nora League. Over 2.5, 1.59. Around 5 plus odds, some bookmakers will give you around 6 odds as well. What do you think about that?
Bro, I mean, it looks so good, but I'm wondering why you've run away from EPL.
The EPL looks so good. I wanted to play EPL with our mini SGR, the 1.5. Yeah. Sometimes they're disappointing. I know Liverpool will be taking on West Ham.
That's
early kickoff. Probably over 2.5 and Liverpool win.
Yes. So, yeah, but it still looks good.
Yeah.
I was just asking or concerned because I have a few Premier League teams on my bet slip. And
once beaten.
You'll let me know how it goes because on the previous bet slip, I think I had Premier League teams and they all performed.
Yeah.
And I believe, again, they're going to perform. So over 1.5, all of the over 1.5s on your bet slip look good, especially the Greece League and the Sweden League Pitea team.
Yeah, Pitea.
Then the Austria team.
Yeah.
then the Bundesliga, your usual league. So it all looks good.
Let's see how it goes.
I hope you're gonna get a win.
Let's see what we have on Sunday.
On Sunday we have 5 teams and two teams from the same league, and I know you will fight me on this one, but
let's see.
Here we go. St. Mirren vs Rangers. Once bitten, twice shy. Scotland. Rangers win.
Rangers win. Okay.
Yeah. And then Tottenham Hotspur. Let me remove my specs so that I see properly.
I can hold them for you so that at
please
least.
Please do.
Maybe and you're not seeing them well because of them.
Tottenham Hotspurs versus Arsenal. That's why I actually took off my spectacles.
Yes.
What do you see there?
Both teams scoring over 2.5 and Arsenal win. Yes.
You think so?
Yes.
Well, that's close enough, but I decided to play very, very, very safe.
Over 1.
I know you're going to love this one. Yes. Yep. Over 1.5. And then Dundee United versus Celtic.
Another Scotland. Celtic win. Over 1.5.
No, I said Celtic win.
Okay.
And then our favorite league, Norway Eliteserien League, KFUM Oslo versus SK Brann, over 2.5 goals. And then lastly, on the bet slip, is Manchester City playing Nottingham away from home, over 2.5 goals.
Wow.
What do you think about this?
Of course, City over 2.5, Arsenal, Tottenham over 1.5.
Yes.
Then Oslo and Oslo. Brann. I love that league.
Yes.
Over 2.5.
Yes.
Rangers playing who?
Rangers are playing St. Mirren away from home and same to Celtic. And I knew this will be...
I think what I can tell you...
Yeah.
The two teams they are playing, they are not that strong. Because there is a team called Klimanok, which will always make our bets fail. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes. So I think... looks good.
What we can do is, let's advise these people. This bet is... a big gamble.
Yeah.
And it's a big gamble because we have two teams playing away from home. But they have the chance of winning, yet we're just not sure if it's going to happen. So what you're going to do is pick Tottenham and Arsenal over 1.5 goals, add SK Brann over 2.5 goals, then take Manchester City over 2.5 goals and mix with Vincent a few of his side, and then you can make another bet if you don't trust those wins. That's all
we can give them double chance.
Yes.
Celtic X2
or over 1.5 or as well.
That's the safest, actually.
Right?
Over 1.5.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
the safest.
So please let it not feel like we are trying to derail people or we are trying to make people fail. That is a disclaimer. Make sure that those two teams, the ones that we put the disclaimer on, do something on your side so that when it comes to the next shoot, we'll be good, right?
Yes. On Monday, I have 3 teams. Of course, we say during the midweek, we just double our stake. We don't look for those big, big odds.
Yeah.
And here we go. Silkeborg versus Midtjylland. This is a team which Silkeborg failed in our previous bet slip. Over 2.5, 1.66 odds. This is the Superliga. This team from Denmark.
Denmark. That is Denmark Super League. Eh?
Right. Then we have my league. We call it Divisie. Este Divisie. This is the youth.
The youth one.
Yes. Jong Utrecht Youth versus Adodeng Haag.
But funny enough, they always play on Monday.
They always play on Monday.
It's like a very boring league.
And they always win. You remember we won on Monday as well.
Then
that is over 2.5, 1.54 odds. Then the last match is from the Championship. Preston North End taking on Leicester City. Over 1.5, 1.19 odds. That's a total of around 2.5. Of course, bookmakers, some bookmakers will have. I wouldn't mention, but there's one bookmaker from Nigeria, which has huge odds, and I shared with you. When you compare it, 7 teams will give you around 10 odds. When you compare other bookmakers, you get around 6.
Less, I saw it. I think you shared with me, and it was intriguing to see.
Yeah.
Well, did you finish?
I'm done with it.
Right. On Tuesday, we don't have a lot of matches, but we have something that we can try to play by.
Yeah.
And the odds don't reach doubling our stake. But at least it's something that we can bank on. And at home, you can add what you have to this bet slip, because I feel like it's going to win these two teams. So I have the Champions League will be back, and I have Bayern Munich taking on Real Madrid. I have both teams scoring. And then I have Coventry, a team which has brought a lot of deja vu.
United match. Yes, call it United match.
Right, yeah. I respected that match, so yeah. I had to put it on our bet slip this match.
Yeah.
This time.
Yeah.
And it's playing Ipswich. And Ipswich is a good side as well. They are contending for... I think they're in the top three in the championship.
Yeah.
Ipswich.
We're waiting for them to be promoted.
Right. So, yeah. But I went for over 1.5 goals. I feel like it can also go for over 2.5, but the surface...
Or Ipswich win. meaning they're stronger than United.
Yeah, but you know the best record in the Premier League is Manchester United, 9-0 against Ipswich.
Yeah.
So how are they better? Anyway, this is a total of around 1.7. If you go for over 2.5 goals, it will come to around over 2 odds. And that is how Tuesday looks like. If you can add anything else from your side, then
simple
good
bet,
for you.
Simple bet looks good.
Yeah.
Then on Wednesday, you have three teams. Kickoff at around 7 p.m. East African time.
Mm-hmm.
So we have Kauno, Zalgiris.
Zalgiris.
Taking on Banka.
I love that league.
Banka. Which is this league?
It's the Estonian league.
Estonian.
Yeah.
Yes.
Estonian league. I don't know if it's the main league. It's main league.
We call it A-Liga.
Yeah.
A-Liga. League of L-Y-G-A. So over 2.5. Straight win for Zalgiris.
For the first time I've
For the first time. A bit to overs, actually.
Yeah.
So there's a straight win for Zalgiris. Then we have Belgrade taking on Partizan Belgrade. You know those teams.
Yeah, Partizan.
We call them Vena.
That is
Vena
the Serbian league, right?
Vena Vezda.
Vena Vezda.
They're taking on Partizan.
Yeah.
That is the Serbia.
Yeah, Serbian league.
So this is a cup, Serbia cup, and a straight win for Vena Vezda Belgrade. That is 1.30 odds. The third team, of course, you mentioned we have Champions League. Which team and which team?
Of course.
Should be?
Mbappe versus Sancho.
Yes. You can pick the market.
Over 2.5 goals, of course.
You're done.
Yeah, that looks very awesome. And then we head to Thursday, which has also some European games.
Yeah.
And I have around four teams. We have Aston Villa playing at home against Olympiacos. We expect Aston Villa to win this game easy. Okay, not easy because it's already in the semis. This is the conference,
Europa League conference.
Europa Conference League.
Yeah.
So I expect Aston Villa to win that game. And then we have in the Europa League, Roma playing Leverkusen. Leverkusen is away from home. So I expect both teams scoring over 2.5 goals. Just choose one. But I would prefer both teams to score because it's a game that could end in 1-1 or, so you can choose. And then we have a London derby between Chelsea and Tottenham Hotspurs.
And both teams to score over 2.5.
Or over 2.5 goals. But I'd rather...
But what's your pick?
Over 2.5
goals. Over 2.5, very safe.
Yeah, because I feel like it's a game where some madness usually happens.
Yeah.
And sometimes...
When the two meet, always we see
goals. Chelsea goes ahead 2 goals or Tottenham, and then you start wondering why I went for both teams to score and not over 2.5 goals. So this one we should go for over 2.5 goals because there's a huge possibility these two teams always attack and, you know, Chelsea missed to score against Arsenal. They will be looking forward to scoring this one. So that is our Thursday bet. And before we give our train bet, you are watching from home up to this point. You know you love our tips and we appreciate you so much. That's why we always give you tips every week in, week out. And remember to hit that like button and comment where you're watching from because we really, really appreciate you. So we also agreed that we will be giving out train bet codes until the end of the season. And for the bet of around 200 odds plus, the last one didn't go so well, but we're going to sit down and craft another. And we will have that code here. And we'll also mention the bookie from which the code will come from. So make sure you stay tuned. We'll also provide it in our Telegram channel. Yeah, so... That is it, as usual.
Yeah.
We wish you the best of luck. Remember to bet responsibly. Stake
what you can afford to lose.
Yes. And
betting is not for the people under the age of 18
years. So we've come.
But I love how Rock places his bets.
Uh-huh.
Just 1 shilling. Like, uh-huh. He's okay with that.
But you know,
whether he loses or he wins, just okay.
But you know, if he would be in Cameroon, I think he wouldn't be betting, because betting is not for the people who are under the age of 25 over there. We've come to the end of the BetSlip section. My name is Brian.
They call me Vincentius.
And this is the Liquid Sports Show. Vincentius.
Vincentius cu cramă cu vin. Vincentius. Vincentius cu făduș cu mine. Vincentius. 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 Vincentius.